There was a country where people loved tomatoes. One summer, they had unusually bad conditions, and tomatoes didn't grow well, and the small amount of tomatoes that was produced came to the market, and because it took much more effort, much more money to produce them, the prices went up. And they went up significantly, so poor people were unable to buy them. The government, and at that time, this country had a very socialistic, a very progressive government, decided that they have to do something about that. And they issued a decree. What government can do? Government can issue decrees, right? Government cannot grow tomatoes. So they issued a decree that stated that the producers of tomatoes cannot sell the tomatoes above certain price and they quote the price for the last year. Now, poor people were very happy. And of course, they ran to the voting booth and voted for the government again and again. They were happy. Why? Because they loved tomatoes and now they were able to buy tomatoes for a very small amount of money. Now let's take a look on the other side. The tomato growers were not very happy because they were selling tomatoes for the prices that were actually less than what they invested, what they had to pay in order to bring tomatoes, to grow tomatoes and bring tomatoes to the market. Now, next year, no one grew tomatoes because there was this standing order that you cannot sell tomatoes for more than a certain price. And the growers thought about it, and went to other vegetables or other food that they could grow and sell without restrictions. So next year, there were no tomatoes on the market. Not for the rich, not for the poor, for anyone. Only several risky farmers grew tomatoes in secret and sold them for exuberant prices on the black market. So, no tomatoes, or very small amount of tomatoes for huge amount of money. Do you think that the government had good intentions? Obviously, yeah, of course they had good intentions. They wanted for everyone to be able to afford tomatoes. Do you think that results were as they envisioned? Do you think that results were good? No. So good intentions didn't produce good results. Story number two. I call it a lottery story. There was an island. Among other islands, large population, about 1 million people live there. They were very poor. Other islands had railway and cars and air conditioners and a lot of other things that civilization brings, but this island didn't have anything. So the elders who lived in the island and who were kind of heads of this island got together and began to think what to do. And they began to ask other islanders what we're lacking, why we don't have all these fruits of civilization. And they were told that probably they don't have good education. And they didn't have good education, they could create things, they couldn't build things, and that's why they were lacking. So they thought and thought and thought about that, and they decided to create good school and created a university, but they didn't have money for that. How to put together money? Here we are. They decided to start a lottery. A lottery that everyone on the island, if 1 million people will buy 1 million tickets, $1 each, they will get $1 million dollars a month. They would use $500,000 as a price to make an incentive for people to buy tickets. And second half, they would use for education, to bring good professors, to build good university, and then a new life would start. They thought about that, they decided, and they did it. Islanders went crazy about the idea. Everyone wanted to, of course, win $500,000 because a huge amount of money for them. So months, 2 months, 3 months, a year, every month, every islander would buy a ticket, and every month the topic of conversation was about the guy or gal who won. and one of them built an airplane with the money that he won and now flying all over the world. Another one drank himself to death, and the third one built a house on top of the mountain. So every time they were kind of talking about that and dreaming about it, and everyone knew exactly what he would do if he would win his $500,000. There was a boy by the name Iggy who knew exactly what he would do with the money. His mom was sick, and on this island they didn't have good hospitals, so he knew that the moment that he would win, he would immediately take his mom to a good hospital on the mainland and will cure her. And he was buying tickets and buying tickets, and one day he looks at the winning numbers and sees that he won his $500,000, half of the lottery. He runs to the elder's place where they lived and comes and gives them the ticket, and they look at the ticket and says, "Congratulations, you won." And the eldest elder takes an envelope and hangs this envelope to him saying, "This is your prize, this is what you won." Iggy opens the envelope and there's like 10 or 20, $100 bills. So he says, "Oh, wait a second, but I thought that I'm getting about $500,000. And the elders say to him, "Yeah, of course, you did. We received $1,000,000 from this lottery and half of it yours, but we looked at the people who, you know, won in the previous months, and they very unwisely using their money. So because we are much smarter with the government, we are much smarter than you are, and we know exactly how to use the money, so from your winning, we took a small amount of money to renew the fishing gear for the fishermen, because it's very important for our island. And also we put aside some fund for curing people from alcohol diseases, and also we put aside, took from your money, a little amount to rearm our armed forces, and you know, some other taxes and some other very important things that will be done with your money. It's you who want the money, and you who are helping us. So the rest, you know, $11,024.17, you can use in whatever, you know, way you want to use." Iggy wasn't very happy because, as you remember, he wanted to use this money the way that he wanted to use it, not the way that elders wanted to use, but he couldn't do anything. He stopped buying lottery tickets, of course. And one by one, other islanders stopped buying lottery tickets. And the lottery failed and didn't stop bringing money. And the professors who were not paid for their work left and went to different schools at different universities. And now the island is in the same poor and bad condition it was before. And the elders were sitting together one day and thinking, what happened? Why the strange islanders stopped buying tickets? And they came to the conclusion that it's because they're so stupid that they even don't understand what's good for them. So do you think that the elders' intentions were good? Of course they were good. Do you think that the results were good? Not exactly, right? So again, results, not intentions. Intentions may be fantastic. Intentions may be great. Last story about the same subject. Two brothers inherited a huge amount of money from their deceased father. $100,000,000 each. The older brother, he was progressive. He was very progressive, liberal, progressive, almost kind of socialist, but he thought about himself differently. He thought about himself as an honest and good man. He thought to himself, $100,000,000, it's a good amount of money, but I have some money on my own. I don't need this money in order to survive. So what I'll do, I'll find 10,000, maybe 100,000 on poor families. And he went to the government and he received from them addresses of 100,000 of the poorest families in the United States of America. And one day, 100,000 people opened envelopes, and in each envelope it was $1,000 check. Ah, people went crazy. People were so happy. One of them bought a new TV. Another, you know, redid his this. Third one patched his home. Fourth one, fifth one. They were so happy. For 2 weeks they were talking about that. And 2 weeks later, of course, they went again to the same unemployment lines and welfare checks and so on and so on. But for 2 weeks they were ecstatic. Times magazine wrote about the older brother that he is the man of the year. $100 million he gave to people and didn't leave anything for himself. The younger brother was totally different. He was, some called him capitalistic shark, some called him fat capitalistic pig, a lot of names, you know, fat cat and so on and so on. He didn't give any single dollar to any charity. What he did, he knew this interesting patent of a new plastic. So he purchased this patent. He built an industry around this patent that employed 100,000 people who every month received salary. And for 20, 30, 40 years, all these people, they're working, receiving their pay, getting their medical bills covered, getting their other insurances, going to vacation, sending their children to schools. And the industry brought him personally $2 billion. So when he retired, he was $2 billion rich. At the same time, magazine wrote about him that he's a despicable person, that he didn't give any single dollar to the charity. He was all the time saying that the best welfare check is the, you know, salary payment check that you received for your work, but no one kind of really paid any attention to that. But what do you think, who of the two brought more happiness to the 100,000 families and brought them something tangible and gave them honest life? The first one, who gave them $100 million as a gift, and they bought, as I said, TV set and something else, or maybe they drank themselves to death with this $1,000. Or the other one, who built himself an empire and employed the same, maybe the same 100,000 people. You judge by yourself.